AMH is a hormone blood test that fertility doctors use to assess ovarian reserve. Today on Infertility TV, I am going to help you predict your IVF success using your age and AMH level. Stay tuned. AMH stands for anti-müllerian hormone. AMH is produced in the ovaries and can be measured by doing a blood test. AMH levels allow fertility doctors to estimate two important factors: how many eggs are remaining in the ovaries and, in a general sense, the quality of the eggs. Eggs are produced in the ovaries before birth. New egg production stops about 3 months before birth. From that point, the eggs start degenerating and therefore the number of eggs decreases over time. At any given age, a lower AMH level indicates there are less eggs remaining in the ovaries, and a higher AMH level indicates that there are more eggs remaining. During IVF, people with low AMH levels don't respond as well to fertility medications, and therefore tend to get less eggs at egg retrieval. Egg quality also diminishes over time. One way in which you can measure egg quality is by looking at how likely it is that an egg will produce an embryo that is abnormal due to not having the correct number of chromosomes. Chromosome abnormalities in embryos become more common with age. In addition to age, women who have low AMH levels are also more likely to make abnormal embryos. I am going to show you how to use your AMH level to predict the chances for a live birth. These predictions are determined using computer models derived from the US IVF database. These predictions are based on people who were about to do their first egg retrieval and include up to 3 embryo transfers, including fresh and frozen transfers. Your age still makes a big difference in these predictions, so I am going to break it down by various ages. Okay, let's start with women who are between 25 and 30 years old. If you have a very low AMH level, say 0.5, your chance of having a live birth is low. The total chance for pregnancy for one egg retrieval and up to 3 embryo transfers is 38%. In this low range, small differences in your AMH can result in large changes in your chance for live birth. For example, if your AMH is 0.1, your probability for a live birth drops to 29%. At 1.0, your probability increases to over 50%. At an AMH of 2.0, the probability for a live birth goes up to over 60%. If your AMH level is 2.0 or higher, your IVF live birth rate continues to increase, but the rate of increase starts to slow down. Remember, the predicted live birth rate at an AMH of 2 was about 60%. At an AMH of 4, it's about 68%. An AMH of 6 is maybe slightly higher, and at 8, it's nearly the same. AMH levels higher than 5 or 6 in 25 to 30 year olds do not further increase the chances for a live birth. If you are older, then you still see the same general trends. Live birth rates change a lot when AMH levels are very low, with more modest differences as the levels get higher. But the overall probabilities for live birth are much smaller. Let's compare a few different ages. Here is the group that we just discussed. Here's what the chances look like at 35 years old. The live birth rates increase rapidly at the lower AMH ranges and plateau at the higher ranges, peaking at about 53%. Here is the curve at age 40. Now live births max out at 41%. At age 42, it's 25%. At age 45, it's 7%. Keep in mind that these predictions are accurate for the first egg retrieval and up to 3 embryo transfers. Not all patients, especially those that are older or who have low AMH levels, will be able to do 3 embryo transfers. This would lower their chance for a live birth. If they were able to do more than 3 transfers, then these predictions might underestimate their chances. Other variables will also affect the live birth rates. One important factor is a person's weight, or BMI. For a given age and AMH, a person with a higher BMI will have a lower chance for pregnancy. Finally, if a person was not successful with all of the combined transfers from their first retrieval and had to do a second retrieval, the cumulative number of pregnancies achieved will likely continue to get higher. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: age and AMH are powerful predictors of IVF success. You should use these tools before deciding whether IVF is the right treatment for you. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.